Have you ever gotten in trouble for something you said? Have you ever gotten one of those threatening looks, finger points, or maybe even received capital punishment because your mom or dad actually heard something you said? But then they always start out with this question like they didn't hear you. They would start out with this: what did you say? In this episode, I want to ask you that same question. As you look at the things that you deal with in your life, I want to ask you that question today and give you something to think about. What did you say? This is Bishop Litman Live. Welcome back to another episode of Bishop Litman Live. It is a great joy to share these moments with you, and I pray that you are being blessed by each and every episode of Relevant Word and Bishop Litman Live. If this is your first time here, I welcome you and I'm so excited. Hey, please consider giving us a subscribe. You can subscribe directly to my YouTube channel at Dr. A. Reginald Litman on YouTube. Also, go ahead and subscribe to the Integrity Podcast. You can get all that information by visiting my website at www.bishoplitman.org. In this episode, I want to tell you that what you say can open up the way. What you say can open up the way. I love the Psalms. And in Psalm 91, verse number 2, the writer there says, "I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust." That's a powerful word right there. "I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust." Listen, when we're going through the various changes and trials and difficulties of life like we are right now as a world, what we say makes a difference. And what you say can either close the way or open the way. You see, the psalmist tells us in Psalm 91, verse number 2, that what you say about God and about God's ability can actually impact how you feel about your life, about your future, and about your faith. And he says to us in that second verse, here's what I'm going to say. Watch this now. I'm going to say this regardless to what I'm seeing. And you got to learn how to speak in spite of what you see. You got to learn how to say it until you see it. Some people say fake it till you make it. I say faith it until you make it. Now, here's what I'm saying. He says, "I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge, He is my fortress in whom I will trust." Here's what he's telling us, is that when you make a declaration in spite of your situation, God sees it as an obligation to create some kind of configuration. Go on and give him praise right there. Because what you need to know is that when you make a declaration, God has a sense of obligation. When you declare who God is to you, what God is to you, in spite of what you're going through, God then raises up and says, "I will be that to you." When you say, "God is my refuge," God says, "I will shield you now. I will protect you." When you say, "God is my fortress," God says, "I will hide you. I will protect you from the onslaught of the enemy and from the storms and rain of life." When you say, "He is my God," God rises up and says, "You are my child. Therefore, I will hold you in my arms. I will protect your household." When you say, "He is my God in whom I trust," God says, "There is a believer who has faith beyond their feelings and faith beyond their finances and faith beyond their frailty and faith beyond their fear. They're trusting me. Therefore, Because they believe me to be God, I'm going to show them I am God. Do you have a testimony? Has there ever been a time in your life when you needed God and you trusted God and God stepped in? It may have been at the last moment, but he stepped in and he made everything all right. That's what he does, because he's God like that. And he's a great God and a big God. And whenever you make a declaration and God then accepts it as his obligation to step into your situation and create a configuration, what you have just done is that you have given the testimony and you're not even finished with the test yet. Ooh, you got to learn how to say, God is going to do it. God is going to bring me out. It is no secret what God can do. My God is great. He's big. He's strong. He's mighty. He's everlasting. And he is not limited to the limited confines of humanity. My God is bigger than all things. Do you trust God like that? Listen, I hope you do, because if you trust him like that, he'll show you just how big he is. You see, when you trust God like that and make declarations, God sees it as an obligation to step into your situation and create some kind of configuration. Do you know what a configuration is? It's when God steps into a no-out situation and makes a way out of no way. He specializes in that. But you have to change what you say about him, even when it doesn't make sense. You have to have faith, even when you're dealing with foolishness, because God is bigger than any storm, any trial, any issue that you'll ever face in your life. I just wanted to inspire your faith today to let you know, open your mouth. What did you say? God is listening to you. Your Heavenly Father is listening. He's saying, what did you say? And what you say can bring him in right away. Hey, I want to pray with you right now. My soul is on fire just thinking about all the great things that we could say about our God and how God shows us that's the real deal. It is true. I am that I am. Let's pray. God, thank you so much for reminding us of our ability to speak well about you, because you are a great, mighty, majestic, matchless God with all power in your hands. And God, we declare, we confess, we know who you are. You're great, you're strong, you're mighty, you're above all, in all, and you work through all. And we pray this prayer of faith in Jesus' name. Amen. Hey, listen, if you'd like for me to pray with you further, maybe you have some confidential situations that are going on, I'd love to do that. Simply send me an email right now to prayerwithbishop@gmail.com. prayerwithbishop@gmail.com. Also, if you'd like to study God's Word deeper, and if you'd like to be a part of my e-class, we would love to have you as a student in my e-class. Doesn't cost you a thing, no application to fill out, none of that, no credit check, no background. I don't need your social security number. Just simply send me an email and say, sign me up, or I'm in, or something like that. clearstudies@gmail.com. Again, clearstudies@gmail.com. I love you. I'm praying for you. God's got your back. And know that if you will open your mouth and declare who he is, he'll show you I'm even more than that. God bless you. Thank you again for tuning in. And make sure you hit that share button. Other folk need to know what you know. And that is that your God is just waiting on you. Huh? What did you say? I'll talk to you next time.